genetically modified organisms. They take genes from one species and force it into the DNA of other species. And they can mix and match between species that have never normally made it. So they have spider genes that they've put into goats in the hopes that they can milk the goat to get spiderweb protein to make bulletproof vests. I'm not making this up. They've taken cow genes and put them into pigs so that the pigs have cow hides. They've taken human genes and put it into corn to make spermicide. And for the food we eat, there's two main categories. The herbicide-tolerant crops, they can spray them with herbicide and not kill them, or the pesticide-producing crops that produce their own toxic insecticide that if a bug bites those plants, it breaks open the stomach and kills them. So they're completely swapping genes between the normal species barriers, creating new organisms that were not part of the evolutionary process.
General public has the impression that genetic engineering is somehow a precise science. More accurately, it's submicroscopic shooting from the hip.
The very process of genetic engineering creates unpredicted side effects. You take a gene and make millions of copies, and then put them in a gun, literally, and then shoot that gun into a plate of millions of cells. And then you clone those cells into a plant.
Typically, what they will put onto that is a virus or a part of a virus in order to turn that gene on.
Now, the process of insertion plus cloning creates massive collateral damage. There can be hundreds or thousands of mutations up and down the DNA, and hundreds or thousands of genes can change their levels of expression in the naturally functioning plant. This creates unpredicted side effects.
From a biophysics perspective, when we look at the signature now of that entire gene sequence, it's foreign. It does not exist anywhere in nature. And therefore, our immune system, which is truly a grand electromagnetic sensor system, looks at that material, that gene sequence that is supposed to be food, whether it's soy or corn or whatever it might be, looks at that and says, I've never seen that sequence ever. It doesn't exist in nature. It's foreign. It attacks. It creates an inflammatory reaction and attacks that sequence.
Many of the diseases that we deal with, in fact, most of the diseases that we deal with, have as a source inflammation. Many of them, the source is inflammation in the gut, which is, of course, the first interface between the body and any kind of food, including GMO food.
In 1996, genetically engineered soy and corn were introduced into the American diet. Since then, numerous digestive disorders related to gut inflammation have been on the rise in the U.S. population. Is this just a coincidence? But inflammation creates additional serious disorders unrelated to digestion.
So I think we should probably look at allergies. I'm sure we should look at autoimmune diseases. And basically anything that's related to inflammation, heart disease, kidney disease, diabetes, I mean, it doesn't stop. Thyroid disease.